Inside one of the tightest security cordons seen in London, Kenneth Howarth's family, friends and colleagues shared the grief of his widow Anne, his son Stephen and daughter Susan. Chelsea Barracks, home of the Irish Guards and scene of an earlier IRA outrage, opened its chapel doors to a police force in mourning. Virtually every top policeman in London was inside. Outside, guardsmen armed with rifles, bayonets and pistols, police, some with sniffer dogs, others with security mirrors, checked everything that moved and sealed off surrounding streets. Sir David told 500 mourners that Mr. Howarth displayed a cool, calculated courage. His bravery was not spontaneous but measured. His professionalism always risked the highest penalty. The last post played, onward Christian soldiers sung, six policemen carried the coffin. The pallbearers, four bomb squad colleagues, and two of the men who drive them to hoax and real emergencies. As the cortege left the barracks for a private burial service in West London, a widowed wife, son, and daughter displayed, as Sir David McNeice said, the same strength and courage that was so much a part of Kenneth Howarth. David Bellin at Chelsea Barracks for Thames News.